In these sequence of modules, we're going to look at questions like, are property rights important for economic development? Does getting health insurance make you healthier? And are humans causing global warming? But to answer questions like these, we need to know, what does it mean for humans to cause global warming? What is causality exactly? So to get at this, let's think about some really simple examples from your everyday life. It's the morning, your alarm is going off, blaring just in your ear, and you hit snooze, and the alarm stops blaring. If you hadn't have hit snooze, it would have kept going. So by hitting the snooze button, you cause the alarm to stop. Once you finally get up, you head into the kitchen, time to eat some breakfast. Say you pour a bowl of cereal, and you get out some milk. And then you pour the milk into the cereal. Well, if you hadn't have poured the milk, milk wouldn't have come out of the carton. So by pouring that milk, you cause the milk to come out. Okay. Now these are pretty simple examples of causality. Pretty easy to determine because you do something and immediately you see the outcome. In other cases, it's not so easy. So think about your decision of what to eat for breakfast. Say you eat sugar-free cereal with skim milk instead of maybe a stack of pancakes with syrup all over the place. Well, that decision to eat healthy may affect how healthy you are in your old age, okay? But that's a long time from now. So you can't wait around to see how healthy you are. You have to make this decision every single day. So how do you know what to do? Even worse, there are other decisions you may make that may also affect how healthy you are in your old age, like maybe you exercise every day. Well, is that good for your old age health? Who knows? That's a question of causality. Now, many other people besides you in your daily life face these questions. So suppose it's the weekend and you're watching your favorite football team play. Now, the game's almost over, and unfortunately the team's down by 7 points, but they do have the ball, okay? But it's fourth down. So what should they do? Should they go for it or not? And if they go for it, should they run it or should they pass it? Well, suppose they go for it, and to your immense happiness, the running back makes it down to the end of the field, gets a touchdown, ties the game. So what caused the touchdown? Was it the decision to go for it, or was it the decision to run it instead of passing it, or was it something else altogether? Well, if you want to win football games, it would be really nice to know what the answer is. So that's a question of causality. Now, businesses, institutions, and government face these same questions in their decisions, such as if a firm wants to raise prices, what's going to happen? If Congress passes a new law, what's going to happen? These are questions of causality. So basically, causality is the claim that if I do something, if I intervene and change something, some specific outcome is going to happen. If I hit the alarm snooze button, then the alarm will stop blaring. That's a causal claim. So causality is about when we manipulate policy, what's going to happen to outcomes. So in these modules, we're going to look at a lot of examples of causal questions in public policy and how we answer them quantitatively.